you know, with next gen, somebody wins one week and runs 30th the next. So, you know, I'd like to sit here and tell you, Kelly, yeah, we're going next week to Texas and we'll lead every lap and win the race. But as you can tell, there's it's not that simple. You know, I think as a whole, the Fords seem to be more competitive on the short tracks. So that's probably part of our strength. The mile and a halves have been, you know, a struggle. So I hope we can go to Texas and have a good run next week. And think we'll run really well at Talladega if we can not get wrecked. But in that sense, it's hard to say. You know, it's kind of one week at a time, Kelly.
All right, go ahead, Matt.
Matt Weaver, Racing America. From a business standpoint, winning the races at Daytona and now winning the Bristol Night Race, in what ways does being able to give those moments to your partners help you kind of build another foundation on this company as you guys want to grow?
Yeah, I mean, we want to get back to being at least a four-car team. That's been our goal all along. Before you can get to a four-car team, you got to get to a three-car team. Before you can get to a three-car team, you have to be relevant as a two-car team. And so for us, again, relevancy, Matt, is winning races, multiple races a year with both your cars and competing for playoffs. Obviously, we're not in the playoffs with either of our cars, so we have more work to do. But, you know, our stated goal internally is to get back to being a four-car team. And that's not going to happen if you're not winning races and you're not relevant as a two-car team. So this is a good step forward for us. We got a long way still to go. We need to be able to win multiple races a year. But before you can do that, you got to win first race. So not to take anything away from today.
And then a follow-up on Nate's question. To your point, like, I think this car has definitely made intermediate tracks, bigger tracks better, right? And then the challenge so far has been short tracks. Do you have enough data now between, you know, here and Martinsville as far as a direction you would like to, as an owner and a driver, point NASCAR towards, whether it's tire fall off or aero or what have you?
Yeah, you know, I don't have a perfect answer for that probably at the moment, Matt. I know we won't get there unless we try. So I think there's some effort being put into those things. I couldn't specify what they are, but certainly we have some room to continue to grow and be better. No problem.
All right, Stephen, go ahead.
Stephen Toronto, CBS Sports. Brad, you alluded to this a little earlier, but obviously this isn't your first time winning a race as a car owner. You did it plenty of times with BKR in the Truck Series. Also not your first time winning a cup race. You've done it so many times as a driver. And you mentioned the duels at Daytona. It's not necessarily the first time winning with RFK Racing. So does that make the feeling of winning a points race with RFK Racing more of a satisfactory feeling than necessarily a high of elation or spike in emotion, anything like that?
Yeah. We've had an up and down year. So you do have to enjoy the wins, no doubt. But I also want to keep perspective and, you know, what becomes really natural inside of any company or and specifically in racing is when you win to kind of become complacent. And so I naturally probably hedge against that maybe even too much and don't enjoy the moments as much as we should. But that said, we got a lot more that we need to do and that I want to see us do to continue to be in a position to win more races than we've been in this year. And this is certainly a good sign, and I'm really proud of everyone in our company, but we have got to keep our head down. We have got to keep getting better.